Bloody hells. Literally. Just when I think I've got a grasp on our dilemma, a devil shows up. No matter. We've dealt with every other oddity thrown at us lately. We can handle this one too. Now, as for this Raphael, he knows our secret. He claims he can help. What do you make of him? I suppose it was a lot to take in. A devil sought us out, teased us with his help, but he also stared as if we were the banquet, rather than the one on the table. We can't hedge our bets here. Best we decide how to deal with him, if at all. Good, you got there eventually. I know people who work much like our new acquaintance does. You don't need a scourge or a rack to break people. Fear and self-doubt are sufficient. When actual pain comes, the victim's already done the heavy lifting for their torturer. There were no right answers with that devil. He was toying with his food, us. Perhaps you didn't. See? Sowing doubt is an old trick. Watch out for it.
The Devil with the Silver Tongue. An old fairy tale my father read to me. The kind with a hero, a villain, and a moral. A farmer made a deal with the devil, so the story goes. In exchange for the farmer's dearest fruit, the devil granted him a bottomless coin purse. The farmer's dearest fruit, naturally, was no apple nor peach, but his beloved daughter. We can learn a lot from fairy tales, don't you think? That's because you still have hope, but when he becomes your last hope, remember this. He'll require of you what you're least ready to part with, and then require more still. You might think you'd give up anything for a cure, but the devil won't take just anything. He'll take everything.
This devil, Raphael, flaunts his paltry wings as if he wants to impress us. You saw the red dragon slaying his infernal kin above hell's fires, did you not? Next to a dragon, the devil's a gnat. When I am Kithrak, I will take my queen Vlakith, his head as a trophy. Githyanki Knights, the riders that chase the Nautiloid. They are the commissars and enforcers of my Queen Vlakith's will. Vlakith bestows no greater honor. To wield a Kithrak silver sword is my destiny. I will earn my queen's favor, and I will conquer every layer of hell should she command it. The Geich are my kind's mortal enemy. It is not unusual for the Kithrak to give chase. To penetrate the hells, this is unusual. But I'm not one to question the wisdom of my queen. I can see but to the horizon. Vlakith's sight pierces the many plains.
are you?
I'd rather not turn my back on you, if it's all the same. Ahead. Looks like they're laying an ambush.
Of all that is holy, I've never clapped eyes on your poor sister.
Drop the act, hag. You was the last to see me, Rena.
Just let her go. Please.
Thank goodness you're here, sweetie. I don't know what's come over these boys.
Stop this. We won't ask again.
Sweetie, be careful!
She's with the hag!
Don't bloody stand there gaping. Get her!
Those poor boys were looking for their little sister, Mayreen. This is all my fault. Mayreen begged me not to breathe a word if they came. That poor thing would be distraught. I'd best get going, but please stop by my house.
A chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. You blink, and the wilderness changes. A swamp, stinking and insidious, assaults your senses.
I haven't spent much time with helpless old ladies. Was that normal? Ah, yes. I'm sure they were just brigands, and the missing sister tale was a cover. Although, if she does exist, she's certainly in trouble now.
Ah, stranger. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Powdered iron vine. An old hunter's trick. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me.
You're a monster hunter? I'm surprised. I thought all Ger were vagrant cutthroats.
And more. We steal chickens, curse your crops, seduce your daughters, the list goes on. Now, I wish I had half the power settled folk think my people possess. Alas, I am a simple wanderer. A simple wanderer and monster hunter. But I'm no witch doctor or cutthroat.
Something terrifying, no doubt. Dragon? Cyclops? Kobold?
Nothing so dramatic. I'm hunting for a vampire spawn. I fear he's gone to ground. I hope the hag of these lands can help me flush him out. If I can afford her blood price.
A vampire spawn? Why?
It is a sacred mission from the head of my tribe. She sent me here to capture the beast and return it to her.
Capture? And bring it where?
Baldur's Gate. My people wait for me there.
Under all the smiles, you can feel Astarion's tension. He's coiled like a spring, hand inching towards his weapon.
Is your friend ill? I have some tea that might help.
No. I'm quite well. We should go, but you have fun tracking your monster.
Thank you. Treating with a hag. I need all the luck I can get. May your road be kind.
Yes. You're a monster hunter. I'm surprised.
A mystic? We steal it. A simple wanderer and monster hunter. But not true. I fear he's gone to...
A vampire spawn? Why? Yes. Yes, fine.
It is a sacred myth.
Capture?
Baldur's Gate.
Under all the smiles, you can feel Astarion's tension. He's coiled like a spring.
Beyond that, I will say no more.
We should go, but you have fun tracking your...
Thank you. May your road be... Us.
You're a monster hunter.
A simple wanderer and monster. I fear.
A vampire spawn? Why? Yes. It captured Baldur's Gate.
Under all the smiles, you can feel a...
There's a lot to know. I crossed paths with a girl once. It wasn't a good experience. That bad. Let's go. We've wasted enough time talking.
I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is going to come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. Oh, if it isn't my hero. You took ages. Come in, come in. Feel free to relax yourself and have a cuppa, hmm? Gods grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again. I'd lose my head if it wasn't attached to me. Now, I must confess, I told a bit of a white lie. I said I had something at home that could help. Well, that something is me. Forgive me, I didn't want the Grove's prying eyes in my business. What do you say? Want me to take care of the little bugger? Sharp one. I am proposing a deal, but it's different from your little pact. You see, I prefer personal things. One of your pretty little peepers. I'll pluck it from your head, kiss it for luck, then back in it goes. Won't take but a moment. That is my price. Nothing more, nothing less. I'm afraid that's my business, Petal. It's nothing nefarious, though. I promise.
Ethel, can I please!
Quiet, you've had enough pampering.
And you, my door is always...
Hello, you're going to give me one of those precious peepers. I'm afraid, glorious. One moment. Auntie needs her real nails for this. Gods, grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. You're quite... Forgive me if I get a bit sharp. You see, I and you, Pet, that wriggler swimming in your brain juice is a bit of an inconvenience, isn't it? Busybodies are not.
Must you stick out your neck for every dimwit in distress?
I'll talk about your wriggler, and that's it. Last warning. You want to play the hero so badly? Gods, grant me patience, people, and ye. That wriggler swimming in your brain juice is a bit of an inconvenience, isn't it? Quick, what do you say? Want me to take care of the little bugger? That is my price. Nothing. A touch, but sure. I'm afraid that's my business. F, quiet, ye. And you.
I can just walk into Holmes now. This gets better and better.
Here lies Connor, beloved husband, and a tasty little morsel.
It's getting stronger.
They come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out! Has that wriggler eaten your brain already? Leave, or you'll end up in tonight's stew. We'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating.
Crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through. Not again. Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet, gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, removing limb by painstaking limb. She cackles, the man's remaining flesh twisted and contorted, becoming the twisted surface of the door before you. Flee, you feel it cry. A scene appears in your mind. Two paladins and a cleric marching through the door, shrouded in the glow of the divine. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair. Screams of terror pierce the air. The door stays. Its form flickers, and you realize that the door is transparent. The door shudders. You see that with a jerk, you're...
I see what's to come.
You realize there's magic at work. Some type...
Me. Dead. Dead! Flesh rotten, bones shining! Lies! All future! Always up, gods. Don't hurt me. Oh, please. Not drow. For mind dripping, flesh peeling, mind flayer. No! Away! Away!
You feel crushing waves of fear. As is she coming? Flee. You've a scene. Weapon scream.
You let them in!
The door. You see the hag. With a jerk. You feel the barest hint. You see that with a jerk.
Don't look. Don't!
You feel the barest hint of you see with a jerk. Fresh, sweet-smelling water gurgle. The warm rush of power flows.
Thank you. Yeah.
Fresh, sweet-smelling water, the warm... You spot a name on the dog's collar. Scratch.
Something?
I was watching you at the Grove Gate. Where'd you learn moves like that? Or a knack for seeing in the dark, for that matter. Handy for all those Ks will definitely, absolutely be roaming. The Blade's not often keen on sharing his glory. But if he has to, better it be with a champ like you. Then let the forests part, and now let's get some rest.
You don't sleep well, flitting between dreams and nightmares. Maybe you wake up because you know something is wrong. Or maybe you just get lucky.
Shit. No, it's not what it looks like, I swear. I wasn't going to hurt you. I just needed, well, blood.
There, in dim firelight, you see him for what he really is. A vampire. A slave to sanguine hunger.
I've never killed anyone. Well, not for food. I feed on animals, boars, deer, kobolds, whatever I can get. But it's not enough. Not if I have to fight. I feel so weak. If I just had a little blood, I could think clearer, fight better. Please. At best, I was sure you'd say no. More likely, you'd ram a stake through my ribs. No. I needed you to trust me.
And you can trust me. Thank you. Do you think you could trust me just a little further? I only need a taste. I swear. Really? Of course. Not one drop more.
He holds you carefully, delicately, until he strikes. It's like a shard of ice into your neck, a quick, sharp pain that fades to throbbing numbness. Your breath catches, your pulse quickens. You lean into him, losing yourself. You can feel your blood racing, coursing through both your bodies. A gentle, numb feeling starts to spread. You feel a little cold, but that's all. There's no more pain, no more fear, no more struggle. It's all over. You don't sleep well, flitting between dreams and nightmares. Maybe you wake up because you know something is wrong. Or maybe you just get lucky.
Shit. No, it's not what it looks like. I swear. I wasn't going to hurt you. I just needed, well, blood.
There, in dim firelight, you see him for what he really is. A vampire. A slave to sanguine hunger.
It's not what you think. I'm not some monster. I feed on animals. Boars, deer, kobolds, whatever I can get. I'm just too slow right now. Too weak. If I just had a little blood, I could think clearer. Fight. No. I only need a taste. Really?
He holds you carefully, delicately, until he strikes. It's like a shard of ice into your neck. You lean into him, losing yourself. You can feel your blood racing, coursing through both your bodies. A gentle, numb feeling starts to spread. You can hear how weak your voice is. So can... You don't say you. There, in dim fog.
If I just. No. I only need a tank.
It's like a shard of ice into your neck. A quick, sharp pain that fades till you lean into him, losing yourself. You can feel your blood racing, coursing through both your bodies. A gentle, numb feeling starts to spread. You can hear how weak your voice is. So can he. But he doesn't care. You don't sleep well. Maybe you wake.
No.
There, in dim firelight, you.
I've never killed anyone. Well, not for food. I feed on animals, boars, deer, If I just. No. I only need a tank. Really?
It's like a shard of ice into your neck. A quick, sharp pain that fades to throbbing numbness. Your breath catches. Your pulse quickens.
Oh, of course. Was amazing. My mind is finally clear. I feel strong. I feel happy. Shouldn't take long. So many people need killing. Now, if you'll excuse me, you're invigorating, but I need something more filling.
You watch as he stalks towards the forest, stronger, more confident, ready to hunt.
This is a gift, you know. I won't forget it. Good morning. How do you feel? It'll pass. Just be glad I'm not a true vampire. A bite from them and you might wake up as a vampire spawn, like my good self. All of a vampire's hunger, but few of their powers. Oh no, I should be cinders in this light. I hadn't seen the sun for 200 years before we crashed here. Someone, or something, wants me alive. They've changed the rules. Some of the rules, at least. I can enter homes uninvited, but running water still burns like acid. As for my other quirks, well, we can figure those out in time. You're such a sweetheart. I'm just glad you're being sensible about these revelations. I was worried people might turn up with torches and pitchforks. Although there's still time.
A vampire among us? So be it. But should I wake with so much as a drop of blood on my neck, I will end him.
I'd just better not wake in the night to find fangs at my throat.
Quite the opposite. I'm here in the spirit of openness and honesty to work together as a team.
I'd just better not wake in the night to find fangs at my throat.
There now. We're all friends again. Shall we go? There's a long day ahead of us. Need something? Not anymore. Which is all that matters, really. Oh, there'll be others. I'm sure of that. If Cazador sent one peon after me, he'll send another. Cazador Zar is a vampire lord in Baldur's Gate, the patriarch of his coven, and a monster obsessed with power. He turned me nearly 200 years ago. I became his spawn, and he became my tormentor. It was him, I'm sure. Only he would know to send a Gur after me. It was a group of Gur that attacked me that night in Baldur's Gate. I would have died had Cazador not appeared and saved me. Well, he didn't mention the slave clause at the time. And now he sends a Gur monster hunter for me. It's a message. He's reminding me of his power. Even in the middle of nowhere, he can reach me. And he wants me back. Safe! You think I'm safe? Do you know the power a vampire lord possesses? He can change shape, turn into mist, call walls to do his bidding, shrug off blows like they're nothing. He could walk into our camp tonight and kill you with his bare hand. And you'd be lucky if death was the worst thing that happened to you. You don't understand. You don't know him. Just trust me when I say we need to be careful. He'll send more lackeys. He has plenty of souls to command. We just have to be vigilant, keep our wits about us, and kill any monster hunters on sight. We can't. And yet I cross the threshold like moonlight through leaves. This worm is a powerful little beast, isn't it? What's not to enjoy? I can walk in sunlight, trespass upon any home, manipulate minds. I'm the most powerful vampire in the realms. Granted, the looming doom is an issue, but why not enjoy the benefits while we can? Yes. It's simple. Just find a vampire that will drink your blood and turn you into a vampire spawn. They're obedient puppets. In theory, the next step is to drink their blood. Once you've done that, you're free and a true vampire. People think the biggest threat to a vampire is a cleric with a stake. It's not. The biggest threat to a vampire is another vampire. They're scheming. Paranoid, power-hungry beasts. So why would any vampire give up control over a spawn to create a competitor? Trust me, it doesn't happen. Why do you insist on exhuming the past? I was a slave. A vampire spawn. Kept by the Tsar family. Perhaps I still am. I was never able to resist their commands. But now, I've been conveniently lost. They won't ever control me again. I've already apologized. What more do you want? Unless you're looking for another nibble. No innocence. You have my word. Only villains that we need to kill anyway. After all, you know what I am now. I can fight with all my weapons, teeth included. And if I happen to drain the occasional bandit during a fight, what's the harm? They're just as dead. As am I. I'm starting to feel a little peckish already.
The frog's entire body shakes. It ribbits erratically, as if in pain. The frog's entire body shakes. It ribbits erratically, as if in pain. It shies away, croaking a warning, eyes wide in terror.
Thank you.
Aha!
A fine day for it, yes? What? Oh, goodness, no one really. Just a bit of poetry to clear the head. Perhaps it's working. I haven't sprouted a single tentacle that I can see anyway. I call that a good sign. I told you, a mere chunk of rock. I'd suggest getting some rest before that brain bug plants more stories in your head. And do let me know if you start growing a second tongue or something. How can I help?
Something the matter? We've been through quite a lot, with likely more to come. Care to narrow it down a little? Must I? Find a way to... Oh, there's Eth. If we're truly desperate, we can try to I'm not too hopeful that a Gith creche will actually prove our salvation, but worth keeping in mind. We go our separate ways, of course. What else? If you must know... And before you ask, no. I'm not telling you what I'm doing there, or... I must admit, you've been a surprise. And not an unpleasant one. What's that? Besides, the one person who might be able to help us isn't even in the Grove. We should look for Halsin, not waste time. So that's to say you'd like to pry a little. You do seem like the type, I must say. My, look at you. This isn't the tadpole I'm speaking to, is it? The person I... And that, I jest. It's good to know you're not in time. And now I suggest you let matters rest.
Well, hello. What can I do for you?
You spotted us. Good. It's like they say. Wait. A drow. In the sun. Stand down. This one's got a touch of the absolute about her. Apologies, your lordship. Hard making you out from a distance. Please, your greatness. Was an honest mistake, is all. You'll get no more trouble from us, promise.
Oh, that reeks. Life left in this old thing.
Thank you. Yeah!
Ha! Round and round and round.
What have we got here?
Stop!
The goblin seems unsh...
What do you want?
As the symbol glows, power courses through you. Authority.
Pardon, madam. I didn't mean to doubt you. I know my place.
Well, that's that. We'll be on our way. Do as you like with the pipsqueak.
The goblins slink backwards, afraid to take their eyes off you.
Come on, you lot. Hop it. Before she changes her mind.
All right, then.
Fresh meat. Scared meat. Yes.
Bag of Chimera. Those pustulent thugs. Well, get on with it. Compensation? Is that all? Well, I expected worse from the likes of you.
Take my pack, if you can find it. The only reason those goblins caught me was its weight. I'll travel lightly from now on. Ignorance is alive and well, it seems. Deep gnomes aren't restricted to the Underdark, you know. I've lived in Baldur's Gate for years. I'm in search of a friend. I fear he's in trouble. See this? I gave it to him years ago before I left home. I found it around the neck of a thug in the lower city. It was speckled with blood. My friend, nowhere to be found. But I still have hope. I'm heading to his home in the Underdark to discover what happened. I always help my friends. On that note, I bid thee farewell. If we should meet again, well, we will have met again.
Shadowheart's attention is fixed on a damaged old statue.
We should keep moving. Nothing. The trick of the light. But something tells me there might be a solution to some of our problems hiding in this wilderness. There's signs there was a conflict around here, some time ago, and different to what we've seen so far. Conflict needs opposing sides, Whoever they were, they must have had resources. A little investigating could turn up something of interest. Let's go. It's nothing. Even if it was something, I'm...
Shadow Hearts are...
We... But something tells me there might be a solution to some of our problems hiding in this wilderness. No. You'll understand when you...
Shadowheart's attention is fixed on a damaged old statue.
We should keep moving. Nothing. The trick of the light. But something tells me there might be a solution to some of our problems hiding in this wilderness. Understand when you see it. Let's go.
Shadowheart's attention is fixed on a damaged old statue.
We should keep moving. Nothing. The trick of the light.